Dobrý den. Sentence structure in Czech, or the basic word order in a sentence. After the four preparatory lessons, today we can start the real thing, the serious learning of Czech. Part 1, vocabulary. Part 2, what the basic order of words in a sentence is. And last but not least, part 3, since the culture is indissociable from a language, you will hear the story of our name, why we are called Czechs. Once upon a time, there were three brothers, Rus, Lech and Czech. A nejdřív práce, potom zábava. First work, then entertainment. A student from Algeria has requested more pronunciation to be included in the lessons. Since we will from now include a vocabulary to each lesson, we can merge usefully both and zabít dvě mouchy jednou ranou, which means kill two flies with one hit. Let's start with verbs, nouns, and some adjectives and adverbs. For the vocabulary part, see under the video, there will be surely a link to its written part. All is written. First, verbs, beat, to be. When I open brackets, further explanation is needed. So, brackets. You will observe the absence of a subject. Why it is so? Because the subject may be omitted in a Czech sentence if it is obvious by the context. We are minimalists. And the grammatical person and the grammatical number are already expressed in the verb conjugation form. So we don't need to add it, but only for emphasis. You will see later. Jsem, instead of já jsem. Si, instead of ty jsi. Je, instead of on or ona or ono je. Jsme, jste, jsou. There is no need in the pronunciation to pronounce the initial J. So some people say jsem, some people sem. The colloquial Czech says sem. Not to be confounded with an adverb sem, which means here. Another verb, mít, to have. Mám, já mám. Máš, má, máme, my máme, máte, vy máte, mají, oni, ony, ona, mají. Another opening of brackets. Czech, as many declare, do not use definite and indefinite articles. I do not agree. Equivalencies of both articles can be established, but their occurrence or use differs from the English language. Why do I say it now? This is not the subject. Because you will hear some substantives today. And since Czech has three genders, you should be informed of it when you meet a new word. Very important. So, when you see jeden, jedna, jedno, jedni, jedni, jedna, or nějaký, nějaká, nějaké, you may fantasize of an indefinite article. And when you see ten, ta, to, ti, ty, ta, you may think of a definite article. Ten is for masculine, ta is for feminine, to is for neuter. Impossible to pronounce this one. This being said, Let's dive into the vocabulary. Nejdřív. It's an adverb. Nejdřív. Ta práce. Potom. Ta zábava. Ta dáma. Ten muž. Ten klobouk. Ta láhev. Here it's written láhev with a V, but I'm saying láhev. It is because we would not in the Czech language make this supra effort to say láhev. It's very difficult in the end of the verb to pronounce the V, the V. So that's why you will hear this often. Something is written and it's pronounced differently. So láhev. Hodně. Černý. Modrý. Bílý. These were masculine forms. Part 2. Word order in a sentence. So basic word order is S.V.O, which means subject, verb, and object. This will be precise further with objective and subjective word order, and what happens when there is a question, and which place take the attributive adjectives and the appositional adjuncts. Basic word order. Czech syntax has a subject, verb, object, sentence structure. Dáma má klobouk. Dáma, subject, has, má, this is the verb, and klobouk is the object. Muž má láhev. This order is used in a neutral messages. We can call it the objective word order. And note that the definite and indefinite articles are not used in this standard sentence. But Czech does not rely on a word order to convey a word function in a sentence, as English does. How this is possible? Czech uses grammatical cases, that's why. For this reason, its word order is flexible. We can play with words within a sentence. Dáma má černý klobouk. Černý klobouk má dáma. Klobouk černý dáma má. Má dáma černý klobouk? This was the question. So you see, the flexibility of the word in the Czech syntax sentence structure has two main purposes: topicalization and focus. Topicalization is the mechanism of syntax that establishes an expression as the sentence topic by having it appeared in the front of the sentence. So we can observe that such topicalization brings along changes in focus. Dáma má černý klobouk. Here the focus is on lady, on the lady. Dáma. In černý klobouk má ta dáma. The focus is on černý klobouk, the black hat. And this can be called the subjective word order. But we can also invert this subjective word order into the verb subject-object formation and use it for the question formation. This is one of the possibilities of forming questions. The other is just prosodic intonation. Má dáma černý klobouk? Má muž zelenou láhev? Instead of dáma má černý klobouk. Question. Má dáma černý klobouk? Muž má zelenou láhev. Má muž zelenou láhev? So I'm changing the word order and I'm using intonation. I could also not change the word order. Muž má zelenou láhev, dáma má černý klobouk. Also there is this possibility. And of course in writing you will use this, how it is called? Question mark. Otazník. Otazník, prosím. Děkuji. Now what happens with the other elements in the sentence? So for example, attributive adjectives. They are quite important. They are usually prepositive. So preceding superior nouns. Černý klobouk, zelená láhev, nové auto. Only in some special cases the adjective can be placed after the noun. For example, in the names of historical persons like Karel IV or Filip Sličný or for emphasis. Mám klobouk černý, modrý a bílý. I'm making an emphasis of my possessions. Attributes that are not in the grammatical accordance with the superior nouns, we call them appositional adjuncts, are usually post-positional. Such attributes keep their grammatical form regardless of noun declension. For example, cestování autem, mluvení česky, pití alkoholu. Unstressed words, clitics, form stress units with preceding stressed words. They usually have the second position after the first part of a sentence. Já s ním mluvím o všem. So you have subject já, s ním, stress unit, verb, mluvím, and object, ovšem. And now story time, part 3. The name of Czechs, according to Czech and Polish chronicles, is related with White Croatia in the plains of the river Vistula, the initial part of the great Slavic homeland. Numerous battles had made the Croatia land unfavorable for its people, who were accustomed to live in peace. So three wise brothers, forefathers of the three main Slavic nations, Czech, Rus and Lech, gathered their people and set off towards the sunset. Czech said, Lidé můj a národe, vpřed! Rus said, Ruskie, za mnou! And Lech? Lech was dumb, bless him. I was not. But that woman here, she doesn't speak Polish, yo. After a long journey, whilst Lech traveled to the north and Rus to the east, Czech and his people climbed Rib Mountain. The visionary Czech looked upon the landscape and told his brothers and sisters that they have reached the promised land. Vidím, vidím. Praotče Čechu, co vidíš? Vidím zemi mléka Astrdím, oplývající. To je všechno praotče Čechu. Proč jsem nešla s Rusem nebo s Lechem? Ty by neusnuli. Ach jo, brzy naschledanou. Kde je to děvče? And tell me why you learn. Czech, you learn. Russian. Russian better. Czech. Pff. Lech. Rus. Tak, maladiec.